Hi everybody, and thank you for joining our webinar on systemic sclerosis. And I'm here with the two today's panelists, Dr. Nicoletta Del Papa and Dr. Francesca Pignataro. Dr. Del Papa is the director of Scleroderma Clinic of Gaetano Pini Hospital, and she's an expert opinion in several board panel for systemic sclerosis. Dr. Francesca Pignataro instead is a rheumatologist at the Ospedale Maggiore in Bologna, and she has worked with Dr. Del Papa until last June before joining this new position. I will leave the floor first to Dr. Del Papa and then to Dr. Pignataro, and all the questions can be written in the chat box, and I will read them in the end of both presentation. So please, Dr. Del Papa, you can have the floor.
Thank you, Francesco, and thank you for your kind invitation. Thank you to Dr. Simonelli for inviting me to speak with you about the systemic sclerosis and the circulating endothelial cells. Okay, just two words, just to remember you that the problem with vascular disease is a real problem in rheumatic patients, since they have an increased risk of cardiovascular problems, disease, compared with the general population. And this is the result of many, many factors. The most important is the inflammation, the systemic inflammation related to the disease itself. And this is one of the features of the cardiovascular risk, together with the traditional risk factors that these patients have, and the result of medication effects too. Related to the use of some drugs that are used in this kind of disease. From a clinical point of view, these patients have a lot of problems at different levels, from the heart with the myocardial involvement to the peripheral vascular disease with atherosclerosis and the arterial stiffness, vasculitis, and thrombosis. In addition, in a part of these patients, mainly patients suffering from systemic lupus, suffering from vasculitis, there is a direct involvement of vessels of endothelium related to the presence of autoantibodies, specific autoantibodies directed against the vessel wall, anti-endothelial cell antibodies, antiphospholipid antibodies, and so on. In the case of systemic sclerosis, there is another important involvement related to the endothelium. I remember you that systemic sclerosis is an autoimmune disease characterized by the involvement of skin, internal organs from a fibrotic point of view, and the vessel involvement, with some important complications related to the vessel involvement that are the phenomenon, the Raynaud phenomenon, ulcers, and the development of pulmonary hypertension. This kind of patients have a lot of problems, of vascular problems that are related to a systemic vasculopathy, and then they can have a lot of problems related to the organ-based vascular complication. The vessel involvement is related to the vascular disease that is that is, sorry, but I lost, okay. That is related to the intimal proliferation and an obliterative disease that is prevalent in systemic sclerosis. And I show you the vascular pathology that is the same in multiple sites. So you can see here the finger, the lung, and the kidney. This is a mirror of the pathogenetic moment of the scleroderma disease. In this kind of disease, we have first the endothelial involvement, then the inflammation, the chronic inflammation, and finally the involvement of fibroblasts that become myofibroblasts and the generation of tissue fibrosis. But endothelium is considered a primary target, and only in a second moment the interaction with other cells can drive the scleroderma pathogenesis. During the last years, a lot of pathways have been studied to look for a marker of the disease, and specifically a marker of the vascular injury. But we had a lot of problem related to find a specific marker of the disease and a specific marker of the activity at a vascular level of the disease. This is related probably to the fact that the disease have a very complicated activation of different pathways, and we found a lack of correlation with the disease activity in different systems, and often we had the normalization of the parameter, for example, in clinical trials, despite the inefficacy of the tested drugs. So the discovery of circulating endothelial cells just looked as a novel marker of a vascular disease. What are circulating endothelial cells? They are cells that are the result of the shedding of a suffering endothelium in the circulation. And as you can see, a lot of diseases that have in common the involvement of a vascular endothelium have been studied, and the circulating endothelial cells have been described in different, completely different diseases. In particular, in systemic sclerosis, we described at the moment, I think a lot of years ago, the presence of these cells as a marker of ongoing vascular disease, because we showed that there were a correlation, an important correlation with the vascular involvement related to the development of high the involvement in the circulation in the lungs, and we found not only circulating endothelial cells but activated circulating cells in this kind of patients. These findings were have been confirmed by another group in France, and again this kind of cells have been described in systemic sclerosis, and the same authors found a strong correlation with the activity of the disease and with the development of ulcers. In other words, the levels of circulating endothelial cells correlated with the development of vascular complication in systemic sclerosis. The same has been observed more recently in patients with systemic sclerosis, and these authors confirmed that these cells could be a new biomarker for the disease and in predicting its clinical worsening. In conclusion, I think that this is the starting point for studying this kind of disease of vascular involvement, but we have a lot of things that need to be clarified. I think that in a disease as a systemic sclerosis, in which it's very difficult to study the vascular involvement, the presence, the possibility to isolate circulating endothelial cells is a real possibility for a better studying this kind of disease. Obviously, we don't know exactly the phenotype of this kind of cells, but we think that they could be the mirror, that probably are the mirror of the real situation. They offer a picture of the situation of the real life of this disease in the site of the most involvement of the disease. We have a lot of problems related to the detection methods that have been used, because at the beginning, the first procedure was represented by the immune fluorescence, but the flow cytometry is the most used procedure for the endothelial cell detection, and the cell search system provides probably a new procedure that, as you will see in the next presentation, for an exact detection of this kind of cells. Probably we need a lot of problems that need to be clarified, and we have unsolved problem because we need to better understand the pathophysiology and the function of circulating endothelial cells, and we need to better understand the discrepancies related to the sick numbers. I think that in addition, this kind of cells for this disease, but probably for other disease, are real an example of what exactly in the vessel happen, and the possibility to exact count and probably isolate this kind of cells. Probably it's a new way to front this kind of disease with a well-defined vessel involvement. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Del Papa, for your beautiful presentation. And now I leave the floor to Dr. Pignataro for her presentation. So please, Dr. Pignataro, go ahead.
Hello to everybody, and thank you, Dr. Picardo, for your kind presentation. And I will present you the results of our pilot study about determining the circulating endothelial cells using a cell search system in systemic sclerosis patients. This study was realized with the kind support of the Medical Affairs Department of Menarini Silicon Biosystem and the participation of Dr. Laura Giorzino from the Division of Laboratory Medicine of the Istituto Europeo Oncologico Hospital of Milan. The aims of our study were to assess the levels of circulating endothelial cells determined by a new and semi-automated system that is a cell search in a cohort of patients affected by systemic sclerosis and evaluate their potential as a vascular biomarker in this subset. To do that, we enrolled in our study 19 sclerodermic patients and a group of healthy donors matched for age and sex, from which we took peripheral blood sample of 10 milliliters to perform cell search analysis, and we collected clinical, demographic, and laboratory data. Briefly, cell search system is a semi-automated system that takes advantage of form of ferrofluid technology to capture and enrich the cells of interest. Enriched cell population is shown to the operator as a gallery of images, and an event is classified as a circulating endothelial cell if it shows a phenotype of CD105 positive, CD45 negative, and DAPI positive. And moving to the results, this table shows the demographic and clinical characteristics of the cohort of our patient. We can see that out of 19 patients, 18 were female. The median age was 58 years old. The median disease duration was 6 years. And 10 patients had the limited form and 9 the diffuse cutaneous variant of the disease. Our findings show that circulating endothelial cells levels were tenfold higher in patients in comparison to healthy donors. And when analyzed according to disease subset, we show that both localizing and diffuse form of the disease has increased level of circulating endothelial cells. Moreover, regarding to vascular involvement, we show that endothelial cells count significantly correlate with the presence of digital ulcers. No correlation was found with the autoantibodies pattern, skin parameters, or joint and muscle involvement. And moreover, a patient with active disease measured according to the USTAR activity index showed a higher CEC count than patient with inactive disease. In conclusion, we know that currently flow cytometry is the technique of choice to determine the level of circulating endothelial cells, but to date there is no standardized method available. And our findings are consistently with the literature data showing that baseline CEC levels evaluated by a new and semi-automated method can represent direct evidence of endothelial damage in systemic sclerosis, and they could be a valuable and reproducible test to monitor active disease in a non-invasive way in this kind of patients. And despite this was a pilot study with a small number of patients, CEC levels could be a promising tool for evaluating therapeutic response to vascular treatment. Thank you for the attention.
Thank you, Dr. Pignataro, for your very interesting presentation. And okay, and I will. I have already received some questions from the audience, and so I will start. I will start asking the first one. So, what are some of the current challenges in patient monitoring, Dr. De Papa? This is mainly for you.
I think that we have a lot of problems when we treat this kind of patients because the disease has different phenotypes, and we have no means just to to prevent the development of complication. So we need really need a biomarker for this kind of disease, because sometimes we arrive to treat this kind of patients where the complication are established, and we have no means to prevent them.
Okay, thank you. And I have a question also for Dr. Pignataro. Given that SSC is considered a rare disease,
yes.
What would the challenge be in terms of patient access to this technology?
The main characteristic of systemic sclerosis, although it is a rare disease, is a vascular involvement, both in limited and diffuse form. And but considering that the blood sample could be stored within 72 hours, every patient could have access to this technology by shipping the samples to the a central laboratory.
Thank you for your question. I have some other question from the audience. So. Have you seen any indication of other circulating cells or biomarker in patients with systemic sclerosis? Probably this is mainly for Dr. Del Papa.
As I told you, different biomarkers have been studied in the past, and it was a pitfall. Regarding the circulating cells, a lot of attention has been paid to endothelial progenitor cells, because you know that in this disease and in other diseases in which there is a failed angiogenesis or vasculogenesis, a lot of endothelial progenitor cells have been identified in the attempt to repair the peripheral vessel damage. But this is the answer to a vessel damage. But circulating endothelial cells offer the occasion to study the real peripheral vessel disease. So they probably are a different answer, represent a different picture of the situation. In addition, I think that there is a lot of confusion regarding the progenitor cells, because the real markers are different, and probably they are a different answer to the damage in different moments. So the real source of these cells has not been well defined.
Okay, thank you for your answer. So instead for Dr. Pignataro, do you
yes.
think that check enumeration could be enough to be a decision tool in systemic sclerosis?
This is an interesting question, because they are a mirror of the endothelial damage present in this patient, so they could allow us to identify a patient with a more aggressive disease, and so that of consequence they could be useful to identify those patients who need a more aggressive treatment for this.
Thank you for your answer. And
if we think to vascular complication of systemic sclerosis, we think about two kind of complications: digital ulcers and pulmonary hypertension. For digital ulcer, we have medications, we have a lot of vascular treatment, and we see the progression of the ulcers or the answer to the treatment. For pulmonary hypertension, we have the opportunity to treat and to make the follow-up of the patients to through aggressive treatment and aggressive procedure, just the right, for example, the right catheterization. But if we add a new biomarker just to decide if the patient has a good response to the treatment, we probably have a new reliable biomarker. It could be very important.
Okay, thank you very much for this insight. And so, sorry, related to this question, basically, I have another one that mainly is what kind of other information could be useful to be obtained from the circulating endothelial cells in terms of characterization?
Or
yeah,
Francesco, please. For me. Yeah. In the past, we studied circulating endothelial cells, and we showed that they are not only resting endothelial cells, but they are activated endothelial cells. So I think that from a scientific point of view, this kind of study allow us to know a lot about the vessel situation in the body of the patient, because we can add some information about the fact that these cells and the vascular endothelium could be apoptotic, necrotic, or we don't know, but we don't know why this kind of patient have this kind of vascular situation, of this vascular feature. So to have the possibility to study, better study this kind of cells, I think that could be a good opportunity for us, just to better have information about the pathogenesis of the disease.
Okay, thank you for your answer. I have another question for Dr. Pignataro. So
yes,
that is about what are the future perspective arose from the study you have made?
Yes, it would be very nice for us to carry out a multicenter study, given that this is a rare disease, and this could allow us to evaluate a further correlation with clinical parameters, and moreover, made a more accurate patient stratification, so that we can learn more about this kind of patients, this pathogenesis too.
Thank you.
And just to have more information about the clinical correlation, because if we know that now we know that systemic sclerosis is not only one disease, but it's a disease with different features and different phenotypes. So we are speaking about a rare disease with the patients are not so many. And if, as Francesca suggested, a multicenter study could be the real opportunity to have more information and the more statistical important correlation about the importance of circulating endothelial cells in this kind of patients.
Yes.
Okay, thank you. And I have a last question now that is for Dr. Del Papa, and is which can be other disease in rheumatology that could benefit from these findings from this study, if you can have a more, let's say, enlarged vision about these findings in vascular disease?
As I show you in one of my slides, A lot of disease in circulating endothelial cells have been studied in a lot of disease with vascular feature. And as I show you, in different rheumatic disease, there is a vessel involvement, mainly in rheumatoid arthritis and in vasculitis, obviously. So I think that probably circulating endothelial cells could be a marker, a biomarker, even for this kind of patients, because we are working just to protect this kind of patients from the cardiovascular risk. And these kind of cells have been described at the beginning just in patients with a cardiovascular disease. So putting together all this kind of information, probably in rheumatoid arthritis, this kind of cells could be useful just to assess the importance of the cardiovascular risk and to protect the patients and just to decide for example, for a vascular treatment. So as statins, for example, that have been used to protect not only systemic sclerosis patients, but all the world of cardiovascular disease patient.
Thank you, everybody, that for join this meeting. Thank you, and we will for sure let you know when we will have another meeting of this on this topic. Thank you very much to Dr. Del Papa and to Dr. Pignataro for being here as panelists. Very, very nice. Presentations and once again, thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Bye.
Thank you for the invitation. Thank you.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Bye.
Bye. Bye, everybody. Bye.
Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye.